Hello everyone, welcome to assignment 2 on network analysis. It is based on mesh analysis. So in the first problem, we have to calculate the voltage VAB in the following network. So this is VA, this is the point VA, and this is the point VB. That is, VA to VB voltage is to be calculated. So if we travel from A to point B, so VAB is nothing but VAX plus VXY plus VYB. AX, XY, YB. So if we add these voltage, we will get the voltage of VAB. So it is necessary to calculate these all voltage drops. So if we look in this problem have two loops connected, two independent loops connected by a branch, but this branch is not a closed loop, hence this branch will not carry any current, that is no current through this 10 ohm resistance. So first we'll determine VAX is nothing but the voltage drop across 5 ohm resistance. So in this loop there is a current source of 2 ampere. So 2 ampere current flowing like this. The current is growing from X to N. We want the voltage drop AX. So I1 is equal to 2 ampere in this loop. So VAX, VA to X is nothing but V minus VXA. So VXA. So what is the VXA drop? It is I1 into 5. So minus 2 into 5, it gives you minus 10 volt. Then come to the VXY voltage. In the VXY, when we are traveling from X to Y, so we are first coming with the point negative point. So as first point is the negative one, so we will take this voltage as a minus 5. As the no current flowing through this 10, so 0 into 10, so it will give you minus 5 volt. So X point is negative with respect to Y point. Then to determine the VYB, in this is the voltage source, so we need to calculate the current first. So 6 plus 4, this gives you 10. Total equivalent resistance in this loop is a 10 ohm. So 30 divided by 10, so current is the 3 ampere. So 30 divided by 10, the current gives you 3 ampere. So what is a VYB? So this is along with the direction of the current. So hence VYB is equal to 4 into I2. That is 4 into I2, that is 3 into 4, that is a 12 volt. By another way, using the voltage divider rule, we can calculate this voltage as 4 divided by 6 plus 4 into total voltage 30. That is 4 divided by 4 plus 6 into 30. This is the voltage divider rule. So it gives you 12 volt. So now we'll substitute VAX, VXY and VYB in this equation. Minus 10, minus 5, this gives you minus 15, minus 15 plus 12, minus 3. It indicates that point A is at the negative potential with respect to point B. So this is the first problem. Let's solve the second problem, which is based on the node voltage method. In this, this is the network given, and by using the node equations to be written at the point VA, VB and ABC, taking the D point as the reference. So D point is considered as a potential 0 point. So taking the node A, B and C, we have to write down the equations for VA, VB and VC. So applying the KCL at node A, so KCL at node A, so first this is the incoming current and let these two are the outgoing current. So VA minus VB, VA minus VB plus VA minus VC. And as we are traveling from the point A to C, the next sign is negative. So when you are traveling from A to C, the next sign is negative. So we have to consider this voltage source as a negative. So this is the drop in the potential. So VA minus VC minus 6 divided by this resistance 4. So VA minus VB divided by 6, VA minus VC minus 6 divided by 4. So making the denominator same, so LCM is 12, so multiplying this equation with 2, so 2va minus 2vb, 16 into 2, 12, multiplying this equation with 3, multiplying and dividing this equation with 3. So 3va minus 3vc minus 18 divided by 12. So transferring this 12 on this side, so this equation 2va plus 3va, 5va minus 2vb minus 2vb minus 3vc plus 18. If you transfer on this side, it becomes minus 18 will become a plus 18, so 12 plus 18, total voltage is 30. Similarly, applying the KCL at node B, so VB minus VA upon 6, VB minus VC divided by 2, and VB minus VD, but the VD is a zero potential, so VB divided by 3. Okay, so this will be VB minus VA divided by 6, VB minus VC divided by 2, and VB divided by 3. So to make the denominator same, so LCM of this is 6. So no multiplied with this. So we will multiply this with 3. So 3VB minus 3VC upon 6. Multiply with 2, multiply and divide with 2. So 2VB divided by 6. So transferring 6 on this side, this will become a 0. So VB, 3VB, 2VB, this will give you 6VB, 1 minus VA and minus 3VC. So this is the second equation. Likewise, for the node 3, the equation is VC minus VA, but this, when we are traveling from, but when we are traveling from point C to A, we are pointing towards the plus. So we are pointing towards the plus, the latter sign is plus, hence here we are taking this sign as a plus 6 divided by the resistance in that path is the 4 ohm plus VC minus VB upon 2. VC minus VB upon 2, to make the denominator same, LCM is 8, so multiplying LCM is 4, so multiplying this equation with 2, so 2VC minus 2VB upon 4, transferring 4 on this side. Okay, transferring the 4 on this side. Why I'm taking this 2 is here, so because this current, incoming current is 2, here the incoming current was 1, so I was taking 1. So here at the node C, the incoming current is of, current source is of 2 ampere, so is equal to 2. So multiplying this 4 with this 2, this becomes 8. 8 minus 6, 8 minus 6 will give you the value 2. So V minus VA minus 2VB VC plus 1 plus 2, 3VC. So solving this 3 bold equation, equation number 1, equation number 2, equation number 3, VA is 17 volt, VB is 9 volt, and VC is 12.33 volt. So this is the second problem which we have solved. Let's solve the third problem. In this third problem, we have to determine the value of Vx by using the mesh current analysis. So this problem is related to the AC circuits. So here it is R minus JXC, here it is JXL, here R, here R minus JXC, this source is 5 at an angle of 30, this is 10 at an angle of 0, and this is again resistive branch. So we will write down the equation. So in the loop, applying KVL in the first loop, so we will add all the impedances in the first loop, that is 2 minus J 2 plus 5, that is resistance 2 plus 5 minus J 2 and plus J 5. So adding this total impedances, this will give you impedance 1 by 1. So when it is at 1, 1, so 1, 1. So self impedance of this loop is Z11. Z11 is equal to 2 plus 5 plus J5 minus J2. It will give you 7 plus J3. In loop 1 and loop 2, which is the common? J5 is the common. If we look the direction of the current, I1 and I2 both are in same direction, same, I am taking J5 as the plus J5. 5 ohm resistance is the common between 1 and 3. So, but the current direction is same, hence I am taking it as a plus 5. If the current direction is different, then I should take minus 5. But the current direction is same, hence I am taking 5. Similarly, row 2, column 1, that is Z21. Z21 means Z2 and 1, 5 is common, so they see that this is J5, this will be as in J5, this is 5, this will again 5. Z12 is equal, Z12 is equal to Z21, Z13 is equal to Z31. Diagonal element Z22, Z22 is the addition of impedance in this path. So addition of impedance in this path are 2 plus 10, that is 12, plus J5 minus J2, so it will give you 12 minus J3. Between 2 and 3, 2 minus J2 is the common branch, but the direction of the current I2 and I3 is opposite, hence I am taking minus 2 minus J2. Okay, so this is I1, I2, I3. Similarly, same we can apply for the loop 3. Loop 3, okay, so this minus 2 minus J2 will come here. Diagonal element, that is a self impedance of this loop 3, 10 plus 5 plus 2, 10 plus 5 plus 2 minus J2. So if we go in this equal to the voltages, so what is the voltage in the first loop? That is 10 at an angle of 0. As we are traveling from plus to minus, or arrow is indicating towards the plus, we will take 10 at an angle of 0. Other, if arrow is indicating minus, then I have to take, if arrow is coming out of the minus, then I have to take minus 10. But it is coming, it is indicating the plus terminal, so I'm taking it as 10 minus 0. So in this loop, again, this arrow is pointing towards the plus terminal, hence 50 at an angle of 30. In this loop, there is no source. So, but what is to be calculated? Vx is to be calculated. Means I1 and I2 is, we need not we are not required the value of I1 and I2. We want value of I3 only. Hence, to calculate the I3, I will take the determinant of this matrix. So, taking the determinant of this matrix, so I will calculate the determinant of this matrix. The determinant of this matrix is this. Then I will substitute the last column. As I want to calculate I3, I will substitute this last column by the voltages. So substituting the last column, so this column is as it is, this column is as it is, but last column is for this, and I will call this term as a delta 3 because it's related to the current I3. So taking this determinant, I will get this value. So to calculate I3, this delta, determinant of this impedance matrix, divided by delta 3, replacing the third column with the voltage sources, I am getting this delta 3. So getting divided by this delta 3, I will get the current 0.435 at an angle of minus 194.15. As I got the current, I want to multiply it with the resistance of 10 ohm to get the Vx. So I3 into 10 ohm. So 10 into I3 is my Vx, so 4.35 at an angle of minus 194.15 hold. So this is your assignment number 2 of network analysis. Thank you.